Right. So, students, we are discussing and understanding the topics of the curriculum from fifth module, okay, fifth unit. And it has got, as you could be knowing now, there are two parts. One is voice telephony, the other one is television transmission, okay. So under voice telephony, we have seen what is the bandwidth requirement for voice and how is the structure of mouthpiece in a telephone handset and how the earpiece works. And categorically, there is a difference between the working of mouthpiece, which is based on carbon granules, and the working of earpiece, okay? So that distinction we have seen. And after that, coming to the television, one of the most important way of communication is transmitting the video signals, and television comes under that. And we have seen how the scanning and the transmission occurs from a TV camera and how it is received, and the necessity of synchronization between the transmitting camera and the receiver, okay. So, and how much frame rate should be there. If you want to feel the video like a motion picture, and if you want to see the depth in the television signal, there are some constraints or requirements by any television signal expected, okay. So if the frame rate is like 30 frames per second, then there'll be a quite faithful reception also. And there is a necessity of a synchronization between the transmitter and the TV receiver, okay? So under the, like in that context, we also have seen what is the meaning of composite signal, okay? Able to hear, right? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Right. So under that context, we have seen the importance or significance of composite signal in television. Okay. So in television, we transmit a signal called as composite signal. Composite means more than one. Okay. A club or a group of more than one entities. Okay. Here, two entities. One is picture information or video information, and along with that, synchronization. Okay, so blanking and synchronization put together is one information, and the actual picture is another information. Okay, so the combination of both the picture information and the synchronization related information is called as composite signal. Okay, and learning the diagram of the composite signal and the salient features of that, explanation, all that is very important from examination endpoint. Okay. And after the composite signal we have undergone, we also observed what are the critical parameters involved. Okay. Noise is always a parameter to be considered when video transmission is happening. Signal to noise ratio, SNR, is also another parameter. But most important parameters in television, apart from all those, are very normal ones like SNR, video clarity, on that. But apart from that, we have seen very two distinct parameters in television transmission. One is differential gain. Okay, one is differential gain, and the other one is differential phase. Okay, so you should be very thorough with the definitions of both. Okay, differential gain means as and when the signal which is falling on the receiver. Okay, I was giving the example, like you may have a television channel, Udaya TV, Star TV, ETV, any TV transmitter for that matter. The signal comes to your doorstep. Okay. And you have a TV receiver, and this receiver will have a inbuilt amplifier, and the gain of the amplifier should change in accordance with the signal strength. If the signal strength as such, what is received, is very high, there is no necessity of a higher gain. Whereas if the signal strength which is coming to you is small, then there is necessity of a higher gain. Okay, so this is the definition in the textbook what they have given regarding differential gain. Okay, the system gain will not be constant, it will be different. Okay, for different signal strengths, that's why it's called as differential gain. Okay, and then also we have differential phase. I was telling you people, in the context of color, okay, basically phase means which precise color it is. Okay, red or blue or green or yellow or violet, indigo, whatsoever. Okay, so phase here corresponds to the specific color, and amplitude it corresponds to the intensity. Normally for a sine signal we have both amplitude and the phase or frequency. So here amplitude refers to how intense the color is. So the example, like red is a color, okay, in that whether is it a very dark one or a light red, dark blue or navy blue, okay, that kind of distinction of the intensity is done by the amplitude. So one should understand that color signal components also have both the factors, namely amplitude and phase. Okay, so amplitude is how strong the color is, and phase is which particular color it corresponds to. I think you should be okay with this. For instance, here itself you can see yellow, blue, green, all that, but within blue there are many variations. So color is blue, that is the phase, and how much dark or how much strong it is, that is to do with the amplitude. Okay, and this is a picture I took from the internet. So I mean, let us not be, normally what we experience, especially in this generation, is we get all the gadgets which is ready made, we purchase them. Okay, normally we don't feel that there is no, I mean, much engineering involved. Okay, or at least we will not be appreciating how much of engineering is involved. But I think seeing a picture here, we can make out that television is not entertainment for everyone. Okay, all the laymen, others, it is entertainment. For us, it's an experiment as well. Okay, here this elderly person, the signal, phase, frequency, he is varying, and color combination, is it proper or not, he is checking. Okay, so I mean, what I mean to say is, like, for us, television is also like a cathode ray oscilloscope, an equipment, okay, which has to be analyzed. Okay, the end users, of course, they take it from only entertainment perspective, but we, apart from considering it as an entertainment gadget, we should feel that mobile is an equipment which is designed by engineers. Television, the radio, everything is designed by engineers. The end usage can be, of course, information, entertainment, communication, everything. Okay, so before we go for the theme of today, which is color transmission, whatever is there in the curriculum, a very small bit it is there, and I will try to make it as interesting as possible to you people. So last heck or last portion of our entire curriculum of fundamentals of telecommunications is this color transmission. Okay, this is like a last class of syllabus, but we may have other sessions. Okay, color transmission, to understand the further basics, okay, I want you to focus your attention on this. Okay, by now I think all of you are aware that color means you have many in number, but basically there are three primary colors, because our human eyes are sensitive to three wavelengths. Okay, color basically is what? Different wavelength is different color, that's it. Within the visible spectrum, the white light, okay, there are many wavelengths involved. Okay, all the wavelengths put together, it is white light. Okay, if you diffract them, Okay, you get many colors. Among them, the human eyes are sensitive to red, green, and blue. They are called as the primary colors. Okay, and normally in image processing, for understanding sake, we use the RGB format. But when it comes to transmission, okay, there is a better method. Okay, instead of, am I audible? Ashes, can you just acknowledge?
Sir.
Yes. Okay.
Yes, sir.
RGB is the primary color. Okay. But we normally convert it into another format called as YUV. Okay. In seventh semester, if you have digital image processing, we call it as HSI. I will tell you if I happen to take the subject. As of now, please understand, RGB format is converted into YUV. Okay. So in the picture, okay, there are two factors, two components. One is to do with the brightness. Okay. So the object can be bright or dark. Okay. So that is one aspect, brightness. Another is color. Okay. So some people who are color blinded, okay, they can observe belagaitu, ratri aitu, adela gotagutte avarige, but they will not understand the meaning of color. Okay. So they are only sensitive to the brightness. But all of us, we can understand both brightness and color. Okay. So normally in television transmission, we consider intensity or brightness as one entity, and color differences, two color differences will be there. I'll show you soon. Okay. Those two signals, you can name them as CBCR or UV, like that. Okay. By now, at least you register in your mind, there is universally accepted RGB format, red, green, blue. Okay. So a normal, old or obsolete kind of television certainly will have the signal connectivity with respect to RGB. But before transmission, usually we convert RGB into YUV, wherein Y is connected with intensity or brightness. Okay. Y tells you the intensity or brightness, and U and V, they are connected with the color components. Okay. And here again, you can observe, as and when the face changes, if you see, this is a circle which has got many colors. Okay. If you feel that this is zero face, the color is something. So 90 degrees, something else. And 270, something else. So 360 or 180, something else. Okay, different colors. Manoj, you need to keep in mute. So different colors, they have different faces. Okay. Anybody has not kept in mute? Yeah. Different colors, different face angles. Okay. Yeah. Now you read this, YUV. YUV is a different color space. Apart from RGB, we have YUV. Typically used for color, image, or video processing. Okay. After RGB, we have YUV. Is a color space typically used for color image or video, color video processing. It encodes a color image or video, taking into account properties of the human eye that allow for reduced bandwidth for chroma components without perceptual distortion. Okay. What do you mean by chroma component? Chroma component is nothing but color component. Okay. So if the color component and intensity components are separated, then what we have is called as YUV format. And the advantage of going for YUV format is reduced bandwidth. Okay. If you make use of RGB, you require more bandwidth. So if you go for YUV, lesser bandwidth requirement is enough. One advantage. And one more is, our human eyes are more sensitive to illumination and color. Okay. So both the components will be considered when you go for YUV format. repeatedly I'm telling you, why is nothing but illumination or intensity or brightness. You and we are related to the color. Okay, using the YUV color space can be helpful for image or video compression. Okay, so since the bandwidth requirement is less, in a way it is also a kind of compression. It was first used in analog television broadcasting. Okay, color spaces like YUV, YIQ, YCBCR and YPBPR all belong to the YUV family. Okay, within YUV family you have several subdivisions. Okay, namely YUV, YIQ, YCBCR, YPBPR, all that. Okay, yeah. I believe it's okay till here. So what we have learned in this class till now is RGB is the set of primary colors, and we convert it into YUV format because we can save bandwidth, number one, and we bandwidth requirement is less, means compression will happen, and moreover our human eyes will have a better perception. Okay, so how the RGB is converted into YUV, we can see here. This is a typical color image. It's not a gray image. Okay, I'm sure you'll be able to observe that it is a color image. But this image has got some intensity component, which is to do with the brightness, intensity component. And this is some U component. Okay, Oliver, are you able to see the slide? Yashas, can you acknowledge?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Yes, sir. Okay. There is a picture here of flowers. Sir. Okay. So, of that, this is the intensity. Okay. This is to do with only the brightness. Okay. There is no information regarding what is the color. Okay. Though the flowers, they are quite colorful, there is nothing related to the color here in Y component. Okay. U component, don't take it as minus U, it is actually U. U component is nothing but blue component in the image minus yellow. Okay, blue minus yellow gives you the U component. And similarly, every image has got certain red. Here red is more. Okay, but nevertheless, every place there will be small level of red component. So red component minus yellow component will give you what is called as V. Okay, so this is the original true color image. We call it as true color because from the scenery, as and when you take the raw image, it is supposed to be in the true color. Okay, but later we engineers do some kind of manipulation on that for our convenience and transmission. And this is a separation of illumination as one part and colors as another part. Okay. So before going to the next slide, around 30 of you are there. All of you should be convinced that every image, every color picture has got brightness as well as the color. Okay. So RGB means we are considering only color, but YUV, it's a very popular format wherein the illumination, the brightness is taken on one side as one component. The color related are taken on the other set. Okay, so of course for color there are two signal channels at least required, and they are considered as U and V. Okay, I think we are set for seeing the other topics in the curriculum regarding color transmission. Okay, and yes, in the test assignments everywhere you can expect this question. What are the popular color transmission standards? Okay, and briefly elaborate them. Okay, that can be a question. What must be your answer is, universally, there are three color transmission standards. Okay, one is NTSC. Okay, the full form goes something like this, NTSC, National Television System Committee. Okay, another one is CCAM. SECAM. The full form goes something like sequential, SE, color and memory. Okay, CAM stands for color and memory. That is another standard. Okay, something like we have IEEE standard, ISO standards. So similar to that, you have another color TV standard called as CCAM. And one more, which is equally popular, is PAL. And the full form goes something like this: phase alternation line. Okay, and this picture should give you a feel of how popular the various standards are. Okay, you can notice it after a moment. You should tell me which is used in India. Okay, NTSC is very predominant in North America. CCAM is popular in many countries, and PAL, okay, phase alternation line, is also popular in, or used or followed in, some of the countries. Okay, can one of you tell in India which, according to this picture, is used?
PAL.
PAL, right? Yeah. So PAL is the one which is even now. Okay, though the book was written so many years earlier, even to date, okay, PAL is the standard we follow in India. Okay, right. So fairly we are set with the other topics. Listen carefully. The systems are similar. Okay, which systems? All the three systems, namely NTSC, CCAM, PAL. Okay, they are similar in that they separate the luminance, illumination, or Y component, and chrominance. Okay, color. Chrome means color. Okay, chrome means color. Luminance means brightness. Okay, so brightness and color, they are separated. Okay, in all the three standards. Okay, and transmit the chrominance information in the form of two color difference signals, which modulate a color subcarrier transmitted within the video band of the luminance signal. I'll tell you what they are. So basically, see, when we have three standards, normally the question should arise, is there a necessity of having three standards? Okay, yeah, but according to the convention or according to the convenience, different countries can have the privilege of having different standards, of course. But there is a commonality. All the three standards, the striking similarities, all of them, they separate illumination and chrominance. They separate brightness as one factor and color as another factor. Number one, one similarity. One more similarity, even in color also, all of them are using two channels only. Not that one will use four channels, another will use only one channel, nothing like that. They all use two channels. So that is a commonality in all the three standards. But okay, what makes the difference? The difference is the processing of color information. Chrominance means color. Color information is processed in slightly different ways in NTSC, CCAM, and PAL. Okay, so there are some similarities which you have to write it properly. And this is the striking dissimilarity or difference. Okay, so what are similar in the standards? What is dissimilar, different in the standard? That you have to write it. Fine. Yeah, before we go further, this is a color space. Okay, hope on the slide you can see it. There are a gamut of colors. Okay, mixture of so many colors are on the screen, and this one, wherein it moves from let us say blue to orange or something, this is called as 0 degree, and in communication we call it as in phase. Okay, in phase. Okay, and quadrature. Quadra means 1/4. Okay, this entire thing is 360 degree. Okay, 1/4 is 90 degree. Okay, so when this is in phase channel, this is to be called as quadrature phase. This is called as Q phase, and this is called as in phase. Okay, so certain colors are in phase and certain colors are in the Q phase direction. Okay, Why the necessity of knowing what is I and what is Q is in NTSC systems, the color difference signals, I and Q, they amplitude modulate the subcarriers that are displayed in phase by 90 degree, giving a suppressed carrier output. This would be understood by you only when you learn what is called as analog communication. But at least to certain extent, you can understand it now itself. Quadrature amplitude modulation. This is a modulation technique wherein the carriers used, they are in phase quadrature. What do you mean by phase quadrature? To one modulator, if you had given cosine signal, to another you give sine signal. Remember, sine wave and cosine wave, the phase shift between them is 90 degree. So there are two color subcarriers used. One is for U, let us say, another is for V. So if U and V are the two color components, U is modulated over a carrier which is in phase. V is modulated with a carrier which is 90 degree. It is not out of phase, 90 degree phase shift. So what is the advantages? Some terms will get cancelled and we will not have any carrier component separately. That's why it is called as a suppressed carrier. If not much, at least you make it a point. There are two color channels. Illumination is one group. Another is color. After 10 minutes, I'll resume the session. I'll start a new session. So one is color component one, another color component two. Color component one is modulated with a carrier. Color component two is modulated with another carrier, which is 90 degree displaced by phase. So this will give the suppressed carrier output. A burst of subcarrier frequency is transmitted during the horizontal back porch to synchronize the color demodulator. In the composite signal, we have seen what is the meaning of front porch and back porch. Both are blanking signals. And the intention of using them is where horizontally the scanning should stop and where horizontally the scanning should start. That was a more concentrated. Our previous class discussion was concentrated more towards general analog television. But here today, we are very specific to the color channel, color television. So in color television, the back porch, is also used for sending a set of pulses, which are used for synchronizing the modulated output with the demodulator. So a small portion of the back porch is used for synchronizing the transmitter and the receiver, and this is used in color transmission. So we shall break up after some 5 minutes and I'll start a new session. Ashes, is that fine? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And in between, I have a serious instruction. Everybody should cater to it. Students, by now you would have written the assignment two. Assignment two in the blue book you would have written. And if somebody is in remote place or any village, they can write it in some sheets. Later we will see how afterwards to translate it into blue book, we shall see. But nevertheless, you are expected to finish writing the assignment two by now. So what is expected by you is on the pages of assignment two, you just scan them. You can make use of CAN scanner or any scanner for that matter from your mobile itself. Make it as a single PDF file. I think people can unmute also, few of you. Amrutavarshini? Amrutavarshini? Hello? Janavi? Janavi?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Keep it on mute. Some 3-4 of you, I will ask you to keep unmute. Nikita? Nikita is online?
Yes,
could you acknowledge? Yes. Oh.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Vaishnavi? Vaishnavi? Vaishnavi is not there. Nitesh?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So, what is to be done is you need to scan the assignment, okay? And you make it as a single file with name as your name and assignment too, okay? For instance, if your name is Nitesh hyphen assignment 2, okay? Like that, you make a PDF file. And for activity, we had made the group, isn't it? Yes or no?
Sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
sir. So for activity, we had made the group. Within group, okay, one of you have to take a small responsibility. The responsibility is from all the 5, okay, including yourselves, all the 5 files, you have to compile it, okay? Compile in the sense, file 1, file 2, file 3, file 4, file 5, okay? So all the 5 files should reach me via email, okay? Do not send it by WhatsApp, okay? It will be a document, okay, for me. So there are 11 groups. By Monday afternoon, I expect all the 11 groups to submit, okay? Each group, there will be 5 files, okay? Person 1, person 2, person 3, person 4, person 5, okay? All the students will be giving their assignment to one person from the group, and that student's responsibility is to mail me on the files, okay? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Yes, sir. Okay. So, Monday, we may not have a theory class, okay? But Monday by 2:30, you would be sending me the PDF files, okay? PDF files of assignment 2, okay? Possibly in Wednesday, we will see. I'm thinking of revisiting the first and second unit, okay? We'll see what best can be done. But currently, my all focus is on how much you have written regarding assignment 2, okay? So we'll break for some time. After some 2-3 minutes, I'll send a new session invitation. Okay, all of you can join. So by Monday 2:30, when I check the inbox, I should have all the 65 assignment files. Okay, so people can write in sheets also if they are not possessing Blue Book as of now. Okay, or otherwise, if they can purchase in any nearby shops by any chance, they can do that as well. Okay. Okay, thank you. After 5 minutes, let us
thank you, sir.
Log in back. Okay, yeah.